Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Wang Junjie from Nanyang Technological University. We did a data-driven seed generation work for Fuzzing. This is a joint work with Chen Bihuan, Wei Lei, and Liu Yang. Fuzzing is an automated software testing technique. It provides invalid and unexpected inputs to programs, then monitor for crashes, failing assertions, or potential memory leaks. Fuzzing can be generation-based or mutation-based. Depends on whether inputs are generated from scratch or by modifying existing inputs. Fuzzing can also be dumb or smart. Depends on whether it is aware of the input structure. Structured inputs are normally processed in three stages: syntax parsing, semantic checking, and the execution. If an input fails the syntax parsing or semantic checking, it will get rejected at an early stage. However, several vulnerabilities normally hidden in the execution stage, so it is not easy to automatically generate test cases to trigger those vulnerabilities. Syntax rules can be easily expressed by grammar. However, grammar normally cannot express the semantic rules, so some fuzzers use manually specified generation rules to express the syntax rules and the semantic rules. However, there are two drawbacks in this way. First, different programs may implement different sets of semantic rules, and it is labor intensive or even impossible to list all the semantic rules manually. For example, one XSLT engine normally will check whether an attribute can be applied on certain element. Normally, attribute match cannot apply on the element XSLT copy. If we generate a test cases like this, it will get rejected by the XSLT engine at the semantic checking stage, and an unexpected attribute name message will be given. So an effective fuzzer should be able to generate test cases that most of them can reach the execution stage. So we propose Skyfire to extend the context-free grammar to model semantic rules. And our targets are programs that process highly structured inputs. And our design goal is to generate well-distributed test cases. Basically, Skyfire takes a corpus and a corresponding grammar as the inputs. It first passes the samples in corpus using the grammar to parse trees, and then learn a probabilistic context-sensitive grammar from it, PCSG for short. Later, it uses the PCSG to generate the test cases for fuzzing. We all know context-free grammar is a finite set of production rules of the form alpha extend to a sequence of beta. Alpha belongs to a set of non-terminal symbols, and beta belongs to the union of non-terminal symbols and terminal symbols. Here, to model the semantic rules, we propose context-sensitive grammar, which adds a context to each production rule. The context includes the type of alpha's great-grandparent, type of alpha's grandparent, type of alpha's parent, and the value of alpha's first sibling, and the type if the value is null. To generate well-distributed test cases, we also attach a probability to each production rule and the context. To learn a PCSG from the corpus, we first pass code samples in corpus to parse trees, then count occurrence of each parent-children pair and the context to calculate the maximal likelihood estimation as the probability of the production rule under the context C, which equals the number of occurrence of production rule alpha extend to beta 1 to beta n under the context C divides the number that alpha is seen in other trees. For example, node 5 and 14 is a parent children pair, which corresponds to the production rule attribute extend to version equals 1.0 under the context not document prologue and XML open symbol. This is because the node 5 doesn't have a great grandparent, and its grandparent is a document symbol, and its parent is a prologue symbol, and its first sibling is a XML open symbol. This is part of learned production rule of XSL language. We can see there are only two production rules whose left side is document, and their contexts are all null. This is consistent with the fact that document is the start symbol of the XSL language. To generate test cases from the context-free grammar, we can use the leftmost derivation. We first set a temporary string equals to the start symbol of the grammar. Then we replace, each time we replace the leftmost non-terminal symbol using a production rule, we repeat this procedure until no more non-terminal symbols left. Then we got a test case. Generate a test case from the context-sensitive grammar is similar to leftmost derivation, but each time we choose a production rule whose context matches the current context. To generate well-distributed test cases, we also employ four heuristic rules. We favor low probability production rules and restrict the application number of same production rule. We also favor low complexity production rules and restrict the total number of rule applications. To evaluate our approach, we use heuristics to collect samples and establish the corpus. In total, we crowd more than 18,000 unique XSL samples and more than 19,000 unique XML samples. To do a fair comparison, we use Skyfire to generate a similar number of unique samples, that is 20,000 unique XSL samples and XML samples. Our targets include two XSL engines, Sablotron and libxslt, and one XML and HTML engine, libxml2. Sablotron is used in Adobe PDF Reader and Acrobat. Libxslt is used in Chrome browser, Safari browser, and PHP 5. libxml2 is embedded in Linux system, Apple iOS, OXX, and tvOS. We have four types of experiment setups. First, we feed the samples crowd directly to the target program. Second, we feed the inputs generated by Skyfire directly to the target program. And third, we feed the samples crowd as the seeds to AFL to fuzz the target program, denoted as crowd plus AFL. First, we feed the inputs generated by Skyfire as seeds to AFL to fuzz the target program, denoted as Skyfire plus AFL. This is the number of bugs we find in the two XSL engines and one XML HTML engines. Skyfire plus AFL in total find 19 new memory corruption vulnerabilities and 6 no memory corruption vulnerabilities and another 21 new denial of service vulnerabilities. Among the 16 exploitable vulnerabilities found by Skyfire plus AFL, 10 of them are out of bound read or write kind of vulnerabilities, and 6 of them are user free or double free kind of vulnerabilities. Coverage is another important feature to evaluate a fuzzing approach. Here we calculate the line coverage and the function coverage of four types of setups. We can see our crowd samples initially covered 34% of Sablotron, and after a span of fuzzing, AFL increased the line coverage to 39%. Well, our generated test cases by Skyfire initially covers 35% of Sablotron. We can see that our generated test cases already had a much higher line coverage than the crowd plus AFL. We also analyzed line coverage of the source code file, and we also analyzed the relationship between the line coverage of source file with the number of bugs found in that source file. We found that all the bugs are found in the source files whose line coverage is more than 45%. We also found that all the bugs are found in the source code file whose function coverage is more than 55. At last is a case study. The code sample above shows test cases generated by Skyfire. Initially, it triggers no crashes, but when AFL mutates it into the form shown below, it triggers a crash. When we analyze the root cause, we find Sablotron did an improper input verification. Function substring before and substring after actually takes two arguments as inputs. However, Sablotron first accesses those two arguments, then later it checks it actually passed in two arguments. So when we pass in only one argument, it triggers a buffer overflow condition. We also tested the JavaScript to evaluate our approach. JavaScript is more complicated than XML and XSL. We tested IE for 2 months and found 11 null-pointer dereference bugs. And we also start to test the WebKit. Up to now, we've already found 7 unique crashes and got 2 bug bounties. Our future work is to find a way to better integrate our seed generation work with the fuzzer. That's all. Thank you for your attention. Any question?
Any questions? So this is a very good talk. I see that you applied your techniques to XML, XSLT, JavaScript. What other formats have you considered? For example, earlier today we saw some works on X509 certificates and so on. Do you think the similar techniques could be applied to these kinds of more structured messages and engines that are based on them as well?
You mean we need to try other inputs?
I'm wondering if you tried other languages, basically.
Not done yet. We only tried the XML and XSL and the JavaScript, and we found the JavaScript is more complicated. So we need to tune our approach And also, because some JavaScript engines are very complicated, the interaction between the JavaScript engine and the browser rendering engine is more in a more complex way. And the code coverage may not be a good indicator of the fuzzing. So we try to improve our approach to get a better integration with the fuzzer.
Well, you seem to have very impressive results. I'm sure this kind of technique will be applicable in other scenarios too. Thank you.
Thank you.